Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team. A lot going on. Real estate, let's go ahead and get to it. Of course, I'm your host. This is Santa Clarita's, hard to say first thing in the morning, Santa Clarita's longest-running real estate radio show. I'm your host. I'm a local agent here in Santa Clarita Valley. Our purpose is to make sure that people have the best real estate data. What we did yesterday, because Monday was a holiday, not for us, but for the system that generates our market snapshot reports and also our research reports, we went ahead and got those uploaded yesterday. So you can go to our main site, paris911.com, and when you get there, punch in the words market updates. And once you do, you'll see all of the PDF reports that we uploaded on Monday. And that's our market update show. So it's going to give you an indication as to where the Santa Clarita market happens to be currently. And it happens to be lacking inventory, even though we're pushing 630 units for sale. These are active units. We're still running into issues just because we have such a huge buyer drive out there. Today is our foreclosure update. For example, you track back even into the month before last. So we're going to look at March numbers. Active units for sale in the Santa Clarita Valley cities, and this is going to include Acton through Valencia. So Acton, Agua Dulce, Castaic Canyon Country, Newhall, Saugus, Stevenson Ranch, and Valencia. We track all of those cities. We had 520 to 530 active listings within that span of that particular month, back in March of 2015. Now looking, we're fast forward to the end of May. This morning, right now, as I'm doing our radio show, we have 645 active units for sale. That is a big difference. That is a big change. However, there are a lot of buyers out there looking to purchase Santa Clarita real estate. By the way, we do have our Once Upon a Time in Real Estate show segment, an actual story that I think is going to add a little bit of validity to wanting to hire your own agent, making sure you have somebody that's on your side 100% when approaching something as expensive as real estate. Today's show number is 2015.147, and it's brought to you by us, Paris and myself, our real estate team at RE/MAX of Santa Clarita, RE/MAX of Valencia. Looking at active inventory this morning, 645 active units for sale, and that's at least 100 more than we had just backing up 6 weeks ago. Total new listings within the last 7 days, 98 here in Santa Clarita Valley. 54 properties have had their prices changed. We're going to talk about that this coming Friday. Price changes, of course, can go up or come down. We'll talk about that when we get to our episode on Friday, which is our Finale Friday broadcast. We'll talk about those, and those numbers are going to morph a little bit. They might go up 10 or down 10 or somewhere adjusting around 50-54, but that's 7 day average looking at price changes. Indicative or past shows looking at real estate, we do see that those price changes are reductions in nature. That's where the market happens to be. However, these aren't actual sold price reductions in particular neighborhoods. So if you're looking, let's say, in a particular area in Stevenson Ranch, you're not going to see a downward trend as far as home sales prices. These are just properties that have been put on the market and are being put on the market at more expensive levels, more expensive than the buyers are willing to pay. So that particular time, the sellers have to reduce the price. Over-optimistic, maybe oversold potentially. That's why we built scvequity.com, so people wouldn't be oversold. You're looking for real estate, looking to purchase homes and housing, you need to get what your property is really worth. Looking online, those the estimates and Trulia and those other systems out there, again, that's not going to give you the information that you're really going to require to get your home sold. Some of those systems are going to way over evaluate your property. Some of those systems are going to way under evaluate your property because they work off of a computer program or algorithm. They don't have a professional salesperson that lists and sells property with a high volume, knows what properties are selling for, knows what buyers are looking for in a particular market. They don't have that. They have a computer system that's pulling records, tax records, sold records, and they're not, in fact, some of those systems aren't even seeing the actual multiple listing service. Here's a big number this week. 40 properties have hit the back on market status. They have fallen out of escrow. They were almost ready to close. Well, at least some point in escrow, I should say. And then the buyer decided they didn't want to move forward. It could be the buyer lost their financing. It could be the buyer discovered something about the property. Maybe it had some issues that they were unable to recover from. Who knows? Maybe there's a crack in the foundation. Maybe there was too much settling in this particular residence. It could have been that they asked the seller to repair or replace or fix some issue with the property, and the seller said, yeah, fat chance, I'll just put this property back on the market and get it sold to somebody that doesn't want what you're asking for. Could be that. Lots of different reasons. A lot of times people think it is because of the final thing that I said, some kind of a disagreement between the seller and the buyer. That's not always the case. In fact, that is not too common. More than likely, that case always comes in with regard to the buyer losing financing or the buyer unable to move forward on the home. Usually, those disagreements between sellers and buyers, at least in today's market, we're not seeing that. Backup offer 62 properties went into that form of escrow. Two properties didn't sell within contractual timeframes. How long? Depends. We take 6 months listings. Sometimes within listing contract timeframes, some agents will take a month. That's kind of their selling point, right? They're gonna be able to get it done for you quickly. And then if they don't, they're gonna increase that listing timeframe as long as you agree. Don't fall for too much of that. The reason why I say that is every agent should have an easy out clause. If you guys aren't in escrow on a property, they should say, hey, you know what, if you need to get out for whatever reason, no sweat. But all I would ask is in the future, if you do decide to sell again, please give me a chance because I've already expended, you know, X amount of whatever on trying to get this job done for you. Today is our typical foreclosure Wednesday hump day broadcast. We're going to go ahead and get into the foreclosure inventory. Now, if you want to see all of this, go to foreclosures.paris911.com. Foreclosures.paris911.com. You'll see our main foreclosure blog. Went through a little bit of a facelift. Got a couple of videos there posted front and center. Also, the foreclosure search engine is there right at the center of the homepage. So you're going to be able to search for the distressed properties. You're going to see some properties that are now being publicized as headed to auction. Not the auction that you're thinking of. Not the ones where you get together like Storage Wars and you have all those people with their funny glasses and their big hats offering on real estate and trying to outbid each other. A little bit of a scam. Hey, I'm going to dial this guy up real high so he'll never come back and lose money for an investor. Not like that. These are online auctions, but price of admission isn't cheap. Be careful with that. I would always have your consummate professional explain to you how that process works. And then you can have them move forward with regard to offering on that. So today, current active Santa Clarita, Acton through Agua Dulce, we have 25 foreclosure properties that are in some way or form available. As far as active goes, we have a couple handfuls. So looking at 12 active foreclosure listings currently available for sale. Looking at the prices, no stellar deals, nothing really exciting. In fact, 1 to 5 of those properties are also being offered at auction. Again, not stellar deals, nothing super fantastic. I see a two-bedroom home that used to be a condo conversion at one point going out at $252,300. That's overpriced. It's just overpriced. See a couple others here. A larger home up in Saugus, that one's going to auction. $700,000, 3,200 square feet. Again, not a stellar deal. Look, there's another one here. Newhall, that one's going to auction, a 1 plus 1 at 150. You could pick up a 1 plus 1 right around that without having to fight with 1,000 other people online and having that bid get way too high and make you uncomfortable. So that's what I'm seeing on the foreclosure market. Now, when you go to foreclosures.paris911.com, know this. You get there to the main site, and at the very beginning, it's going to say search for foreclosures. You click on that or click on that photograph if you happen to be on a mobile device. If you're on a mobile device, an iPad, a tablet, it's going to reroute you to a mobile platform. Get a laptop, get on your home computer whenever you have a chance. When you do and go to foreclosures.paris911.com, you'll be given an option to search for the off-market foreclosure. So this is kind of a preview of coming attractions, things to come, kind of give you an idea of what potentially is going to be coming onto the market here in the next short amount of time. And how you look for those as you look at the pre-foreclosure inventory. These are properties that have had notice of defaults filed on them, and they are properties that are going to potentially be coming to the market. But if they're not on the market now, all you have to do is have your realtor professional. And we do this type of searching for our clients automatically. So it's not something extra that has to be done. It's part of our search. So if you're using us, if you're going to MLSBest.com and you're looking for real estate, trying to find a home to buy, and you come to us, you approach me, say, okay, Connor, I want to work with you guys. Great. That's part of our method anyway. We're looking at that off-market pre-foreclosure inventory. A lot of people don't have the time to wait, but at least we get that door open. It doesn't hurt our business either because now we make new connections out there in the world, people that are wanting to sell their real estate or get it listed for sale or whatever it may be. So that's our method, and we're more than happy to do that for you. You want to do it yourself, again, remember laptop, desktop. Once upon a dime in real estate, welcome to our show segment today. We're going to talk about sometimes how people can get too emotionally attached, including the agent. Once upon a time in real estate, I got a phone call from some people that are relocating out here to Santa Clarita Valley. Nice couple. They came in. They have three children. Brought the children into my office. Very well behaved. They sit. They colored. Met them both. Wonderful people. We started talking about what they were looking for. First time buyers, yes. I asked, have you been renting? Yes. What type of home have you been renting? Well, it's been a townhome. What are you looking for currently? They explained single family residence. I said, wonderful. So we started the search on my end, started pointing out properties, the off-market pocket listings. Those came up from time to time. Not super often, because what ends up happening with potentially every seller is they're going to want the best deal for the property. You can't expect one agent to bring that best deal. That's where some of these help you sell models where you're exclusively listing with a particular agent, the sellers are doing themselves a disservice by not offering that property to the rest of the agents at large and the rest of the people that are representing buyers of real estate, getting even more for their property versus saving money with this flat fee commission structure. They're actually losing in the long run. And statistics show that very clearly. But moving through, looking at properties, the clients are sending me inquiries. They found a lot of the Zillow properties and stuff on those other syndication sites. Some of them weren't available. A lot of the others might have been at one particular point, but they're currently not any longer. But we get out. We were looking, wrote a couple offers. We're outbidded by people. We had one particular agent. Their client had to go in for surgery, so she unilaterally canceled the escrow or decided to pull her property off the market before we had an executed offer. So, very disappointing. Finally, we find a home, and it seems to fit the bill. It's one of those where there was a lady that lived in the house. The house was a little older, interior-wise, very dated. You could tell it was almost a hoarding situation where we had a seller that happened to be one of the sellers, one of the owners of the property, passed on a couple years ago. And the female component or counterpart that was living with him apparently kind of lost her way. So you have hoarding issues in the house. Finally, I guess the kids intervened and through an intervention took mom into some kind of care, adult facility, whatever it may be. Property hadn't hit the market yet. Again, with what we do is we do this off-market search, like people talk about pocket listings. You might be going on to Zillow or some of those other systems and seeing coming soon. Be careful with that. We had some clients contact us yesterday about a quote-unquote coming soon listing. Second time I've seen it. Call up the agent, whom I happen to know. He's out of REMAX as well. And I said, what's going on with this? He said, you know, you think one of these people that were calling me would be a buyer, but no, it's all agents wanting to know what's going on with the property. And he says, I have no idea. I sold the thing back in January. This property shouldn't be showing up on Zillow any longer. It's being actually for sale. I said, well, I get you. So I explained it to them and they got it. Moving forward, though, this house was what they wanted. It was larger. It was $100,000 less than the other properties that have sold in the area, but it needed a lot of work. $100,000 might be a little bit more than it actually needed, but it did need quite a bit of work. Not in good shape. So we wrote the offer, bantering back and forth. We try to always explain to our clients, do not get emotionally attached to anything you're looking at. Please, don't get emotionally attached. Very difficult to break away if things don't work out. But what it appeared from all the text messages I had been receiving from the other agent, whom I know referred to her a clean-out person to take care of this property and also get it cleaned up. We were able to get in a little bit early as well, so my clients got first crack, looked at the property, pulled the comps again, about $100,000 less than fair market value, at least at this particular point. Somewhere reasonable, probably more accurate, would be $70,000, because you're going to need at least 30 to bring it up, 30 to 40 to bring it up to kind of where the others would be. Investor's dream, yeah, you could buy that property and put some money into it and turn around and flip it for an additional $60,000 or $70,000 potentially. My clients, they don't want to flip. They just want to raise the three kids out here in Santa Clarita Valley. That's all. Going back and forth with the agent, this dragged on for what was about a week and a half. Yes, you guys will have it. It'll be yours, so on and so forth. I'm telling our clients, you know, I don't know if I would do that for another agent, but it's really nice to hear. I'm glad. Looks like we're going to be okay. They said, well, you don't sound too sure. And I said, well, I'm never sure of this business. Sometimes agents like to speak out of both sides of their mouth. Sometimes they'll tell you what you want to hear and realistically just continue and do whatever they want to do. So the thing is please don't get mentally attached. I know this property has everything you've been looking for. I know it's the one that you want. But at the end of the day, we won't know if it's ours until the sellers, and now the kids are taking care of the property. Not kids, they're 30s, 40s, 50s. But now they're taking care of the property, they're going to be the deciding mechanism. And although the agent's telling us that they grew up in the neighborhood and there's emotions involved, even on the seller's side, and they want somebody in that property that's going to live there and raise a family there because they all grew up there, don't let that sink in so deep it causes even more of a connection. Because at the end of the day, we don't know. We don't know how it's going to be. We countered back. We received a counter. The counter was one of those counter offers that really tied up loose ends. Some of those loose ends, including making them tighter, tightening the noose. But we still had time. There was still time, even though they constricted and reduced particular inspection time frames, there was still enough time. So we decided to accept. And we're still waiting. So it continues on, more text messages. Finally, she says, I hope you don't hate me, but my sellers are going to go with a cash offer. See, ladies and gentlemen, whenever you're financing real estate, there's always a chance. There's a chance that it's not going to go through. Maybe the bank drops the ball. Maybe the appraiser goes out, looks at the property, and in this particular case, there were quote-unquote issues of neglect with regard to the property. What if they go back and the appraiser calls out and says, there's this issue, it needs to be taken care of before our bank will loan on this particular property? Well, then that's extra money out of the seller's pocket. It might be that you were the higher offer in the game, but it could be that another buyer came in with cash, $5,000 less, $7,500 less, whatever it was, but it's going to close not in 30 days, but 15 days. And they're not going to care about appraisal where somebody obtaining a loan is going to need an appraisal. They're not going to care about inspections, but somebody that's going to borrow money and not going to flip it and going to live there and exist there, they're going to care about inspections. They have kids here. There could be mold. With the type of neglect this property had, there could have been big mold issues in the property. There could have been all sorts of things. It looked like it had a copper repipe, but we really don't know. Heard of termites? Well, could have been present. We don't know that as well. Once upon a time in real estate, at the end of the day, the buyers didn't get the property, and it was difficult. Still difficult. Very difficult. And the agent spoke out of both sides of her mouth and probably was playing all parties against each other. Probably. But I am thankful, as is Paris is thankful, as our clients are thankful, because that one, ladies and gentlemen, must not have been meant to be. Probably for bigger reasons than we even know at the present time. I'm Connor McIver. Thank you so much for listening to our Wednesday Hump Day broadcast. We're going to be back tomorrow with our Truth in Lending show. There'll be a Once Upon a Time in Real Estate segment there as well, and we'll surprise you with what that'll be about tomorrow. Make sure you get to our market updates again, our main site, paris911.com. And once you get there, you can punch in the words market updates into the Mac box at the top part of the screen. And when you do, you're going to arrive at our realtor blog. And when you get there, you'll see those particular categories. Well, it's going to be the first. Yesterday's show was 146. Today's 147 of the year 2015. You'll see when you get to that particular page, just scroll down just a little bit, and you'll see all of the housing updates. So you'll see Acton, Kenny Country, Castaic, Newhall, Santa Clara proper, Stevenson Ranch, and Valencia. You'll see each one of those. Click on the corresponding link and you'll see the PDF reports. They get into a lot of things. They're going to cover this week in a particular city, whichever one you choose. You're going to have a real-time market profile there. It's going to cover median list price, asking price per square foot, average days on market, which is an important indicator, percent of properties with price decreases. You'll see those as relevant to a particular city. And with regard to a specific housing type, which I happen to be I clicked on the Canyon Country Report. We're looking at single family homes currently. You're going to see percentage relisted with reset days on market. That's a 30-day time frame for the Southland Regional Board. So if you have a property for sale, it hasn't sold, and you don't want it tied up and showing this excessive amount of days on market, and you want that reset, it takes 30 days. So a day 32 would probably be safe to put it back on the market and have it show as if it's brand new on the market. Not a bad strategy, it just depends how the market is faring. Right now with the constrictive inventory, it shouldn't be too difficult to sell most real estate listings that are priced well. And if they're not priced well, I would suggest you approach your agent and say, hey, let's do a small price reduction. That allows that agent to relive all the advertising. At least that's what we do. Once we get, I don't care if it's a grand, doesn't matter, $1,000, $500. As long as that price reduction's in place, I can take that and run with it and repopulate all those systems out there with a property that now is going to get more attention than it had before, or at least in theory, it's going to get an additional amount of attention because it's showing up out there as far as relisted and has a lower asking price. You're going to see median house size per square foot, or as far as square footage goes, what the averages are, median lot size, median number of bedrooms, median number of bathrooms, market action index, and so on. Now, supply and demand, we get into that with these reports. You're going to see prices, what's going on with regard to local prices, and then, of course, the quartile reports, which are going to cover the different 25% chunks with regard to price ranges of homes. So you'll see that as well. So check that out. Tomorrow is our Truth in Lending show, as we talked about. We'll talk to you then. I am Connor McIver. Thank you so much for listening. And let us know if we can help. You can, of course, find us online at Paris, P-A-R-I-S, 911.com. We're RE/MAX Realtors, headquartered in Santa Clarita, serving greater Los Angeles cities. 661-400-1720. I'll talk to you soon. Connor McIver, over and out.